In this video, I want to show you how to revert. Maybe you don't want it to be part of your project and you accidentally had committed it, so you'd want to take it out but still leave everything else intact. So I'm going to have a small project, so I'll open up a folder right here and then I'm going to drop it in my editor. So let's say we are writing our HTML and we're doing very well, and we decide this is something that we want to commit to Git and we want to just Git initialize. So I'm going to hit Git init right in here. So I'll increase my editor so that you can be able to see. So I'm going to hit Git init, I'll press enter, and that will allow me to track. So I'm going to Git add, and then I'll stage that, and then I'm going to go to Git commit dash M to add my message, and then I'll say initial HTML, and that will be something that I do. So maybe I change my title and then I'll say this is homepage and save this. Of course, Git is going to tell me that this is something that's new, because when I hit Git status, that will show me that something has changed. So I can hit Git add and add all of them. Then I'll commit this by saying changed the title. So that is added. Now, if I look at my Git log in here, you'll see that I have a number of commit messages that I have, my initial HTML, and after changing the title, I have this here. You can actually see right here that I have two commits. I have this commit, and then I have this commit. So let's say I want to revert this, change the title into what we previously had. So I'm going to select this commit number, and then I'll come here in my terminal and say git revert, and then I'll paste the ID of that commit. When I hit enter, you're going to see that it brings this new message, which is saying revert change title. All I'm going to do is press my full colon and letter Q, and then I'll hit enter, and you're going to see that it's going to take us back, and now we have our title of document in here. So if I just do a git log here, you'll see that we reverted this change and we still have everything that we had originally. So that's how sometimes you can fix some of those messes you had before. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to check out all the other Git videos that I have. Maybe if you learned something new, let me know in the comment how you deal with such scenarios in your own workflow. Otherwise, don't forget to share and hit subscribe and hit that notification bell for any new videos.